Hi all, today we are going to discuss about Bayley lattice diagram. So in order to keep track of the multiplicity of successive reflections at discontinuities in the system, so a scientist named Bayley has suggested a time space diagram which shows the position and direction of motion of every incident, reflected and transmitted wave on the system at any instant of time. So in order to understand this, because the theory definition is very complex, so let us take the example. I am taking the example, let us take for example, there is a generator. A generator is transmitting a voltage. Let us take for example, it is supplying a voltage of 1 volt. So this magnitude is 1 volt. A DC generator is there. It is transmitting through a system and the switch is closed. And let us assume at the load, there is some load. So this I am representing some load. So let us assume the value of the load resistance is equal to RL. It is terminated by a resistive load. Let us assume this transmission end is having a characteristic impedance of ZC. So now this 1 volt after reaching this junction, because there is a discontinuity, because there is a resistance of, it is terminated by a resistance RL. So RL is connected to ground. So some part will transmit and some part will reflect back. So what I mean to tell, when the voltage has reached here, this 1 volt, out of this 1 volt, some part will be transmitted further, some part will be reflected back. Again, this voltage when it reaches the generator end, let us assume here some generator is there. So we are taking the DC generator. So let us take the DC generator only. So let me just erase this. So I am taking a DC generator. So DC generator is plus minus. So this is connected like this. Again, DC generator, let us assume the internal resistance is equal to 0. So as the internal resistance is equal to 0, entire part will reflect back. Again, that wave will reach here. Again, some part will be transmitted, some part will be reflected back. Let us assume I want to know after 4 microseconds. So what is the magnitude of the voltage at some particular location of this transmission line? So how to get it? Normally calculating will be very difficult task, because it is experiencing multiple transmission as well as reflected voltages. Or let us assume I want to know the voltage at this junction after 4 microseconds. How to calculate it? So for calculating these things, the Bayley has devised some method. So what that method will do? In the method, so x axis will be along the distance, because we are starting from x is equal to 0. Let us assume it is moving up to x is equal to L, the terminal. This is the x axis, is the distance. So, and this y axis will be the time. With respect to the time, how the wave is coming. Let us assume if it transmit a wave from here at time t is equal to 0. So, they will take some time to reach this junction. Let us assume it is reaching this junction in time some t seconds. So in time t seconds it has reached here, it is having a magnitude of 1. So out of this wave, some part will be reflected back like this and some part will be transmitted to this signal. So let us assume some part is reflected back. So again, this wave will reach this junction in time 2t. You agree with me? Again here, some part will be transmitted back to the generator and some part will be reflected back. Getting this? So again, this will be reflected. Again, it will reach at time 3t. Again, it will reflect back. So let us take for example, I want to know what is the value of the voltage after time 3t. So how to find the value? What you have to do? You have to take the sum of all the voltages coming up to this point here. So using that, we can easily calculate it. Let us take one small example. Through the example, I will explain it so that this topic will be completely clear to you. So what I am doing, I am taking a DC generator. Let us assume a DC generator is there. This generator is having a magnitude of V is equal to 1 volt. So this is connected to a transmission line. The transmission line is having a characteristic impedance of ZC and it is connected to a load having a load resistance of RL. Okay. Now let us assume it is taking a time T to reach this end. So now whenever the wave is superimposed by this traveling wave, so the wave will transmit up to this end. So after reaching this end, some part will be transmitted and some part will be reflected back. So let us take this value is, I am representing by alpha r, which indicates the reflection coefficient at the receiving end. So I can calculate my reflection coefficient. Alpha r will be equal to, reflection coefficient is RL minus ZC divided by RL plus ZC. So based on the reflection coefficient, the wave reaches here. Again, when the wave reaches here, again it will be reflected back. How much will be the reflection coefficient here? That I am representing by alpha s. Alpha s is reflection coefficient at the sending end. So reflection coefficient at sending end will be, because the wave is traveling like this, so my load impedance will be impedance of my line. So impedance of my generator is 0 because internal impedance I am taking as 0 minus the impedance of the where the wave is traveling, that is Zc divided by 0 plus Zc. That means we will get the reflection coefficient as minus 1. So it is taking t seconds to reach from sending end to receiving end, and after coming the receiving end it will reflect back with the reflection coefficient of the alpha r. Again after reaching the sending end it will reflect back with the reflection coefficient of minus 1. So let us try to draw the diagram so that this will be completely clear to you. So what I am doing, I am just drawing the Bewley lattice diagram. So this x-axis, this indicates the distance. So here I am starting from the sending end. So here there is the receiving end. So let us assume sending end, it is starting at time t is equal to 0 seconds. So now wave is taking a time of t seconds to reach here. So let us assume the wave has taken t seconds to reach here. So this is after time t seconds. So how much is the magnitude? Magnitude of 1 has reached up to here. So now as the 1 has reached up to here, so how much will be the reflected back? Some part will be transmitted to this signal and some will be reflected back. So this reflection value will be equal to alpha r. Agree with me? So now this alpha r or the reflection coefficient will reach this junction. How much is coming here? Alpha r. This is at time 2t because it will take t seconds again. So out of this alpha r, some part should be transmit, some part should reflect back. But we have already seen at the sending end reflection coefficient will be minus 1. So this becomes minus 1 times of alpha r. This becomes minus alpha r. Getting this one? So minus alpha r has reached here in time 3t. So this is minus alpha r. Again it will be reflected back. Reflection coefficient is again alpha r. Multiply this with alpha r. This becomes minus alpha r square. Again this will reach here. Again it will reflect back. So this is minus alpha r square. So this will become alpha r square. So when this alpha r square reaches here at time 5t, again it will be reflected back. So what will be the reflection coefficient here? This is alpha r square. This will be again multiplied. This will become alpha r cube. So like that, this will go on continuing. This will go on continuing. So in this way you have to do it. Let us try to calculate what is the magnitude of the voltage at your receiving end at a different instant of time. So I will ask you, after time t, what is the magnitude of the voltage at this instant? Because we know the EMF at any instant or the transmitted voltage will be sum of the incident voltage plus reflected voltage. So how much value the incident voltage up to here? It is 1 plus reflected voltage is alpha r. So we can tell at this instant the voltage will be equal to 1 plus alpha r after time t. So from t to 3t, this magnitude remains same. What you have to do? Let us assume I will ask you, find at the time 1.5 times of t. So above this, whatever the magnitudes are there, take the sum of all those magnitudes, that gives the value. That means up to here also it is 1 plus alpha r only. So let us take at the instant 3t. At the instant 3t, take the sum just after 3t I want to find. Let us assume at this instant I want to find it. So what should I do? I have to do sum of all the values. What is the sum of all the values? It is 1 plus alpha r minus alpha r square. This is the total value of the voltage at this point. So this will be equal to alpha r minus alpha r will cancel. This will become 1 minus alpha r square. Getting this one? Again, after instant of 5t, if I want to find, so what will be the magnitude of this? So you have to take the sum of the values up to there. So if you take the sum, it will become 1 plus alpha r cube. This is at the receiving end. Let us assume at the sending end. At the sending end, up to this instant, what is the value of the voltage? The value of the voltage will be, because this magnitude is equal to 1 here, 1 is traveling, so here it will be equal to 1. So if you take at this instant, if you want to find it, so what you have to do? Take the sum of all the values that are reaching up to there. So up to this point will be 1 plus alpha r minus alpha r. Again it is becoming equal to 1. Again after this instant if you want to find it, again same thing, 1 plus alpha r minus alpha r, again minus alpha r square plus alpha r square. So every point you can see the voltage is becoming equal to your supply voltage only, because your supply is not going to change, it doesn't have any resistance. Getting this? In this way you have to find the value of the voltage at different instances. So let me try to again draw it, so then we will proceed further. So I am drawing the diagram again. this is the sending end and this is receiving end. So I told you from the sending end the wave is traveling like this. So I am just drawing the wave, then we will represent the magnitudes once again to know it. So I will try to revise it. After revising, we will proceed further for remaining analysis. So let us take at different instances. So it will take time t, this will come after time 2t, it will reach here at 3t, this will be here at 4t, this will be 5t, this will be 6t and this will be 7t. So now at the sending end, the reflection coefficient we have calculated is equal to minus 1, and at the receiving end, the reflection coefficient we have calculated as alpha r, because alpha s is equal to minus 1. That's why I have taken the simplest possible one. Next class we will take some complex numericals, there we will discuss in detail, because I want to explain you the concept, that's why I have taken the simple one. So here the magnitude is equal to 1, the incident wave is coming here, so 1 is reaching here, so this 1 will be multiplied by the reflection coefficient, so this will become equal to alpha r. So now this alpha r has reached here, now this alpha r should be multiplied by the reflection coefficient here. How much is there? Minus 1, this becomes minus 1 into alpha r, this become minus alpha r. So this minus alpha r has reached here, so minus alpha r will be multiplied by alpha r again, so this will become minus alpha r square, again this will become equal to minus alpha r square has reached here, again this will be multiplied with minus 1, this becomes alpha r square, again this alpha r square has reached here, so here what will be there? Alpha r cube. So again this alpha r cube has reached here, so this will be multiplied by minus 1, this will become minus alpha r cube. Again this minus alpha r cube has reached here, this will be multiplied by alpha, so this will become equal to alpha r to the power of 4, that is minus. Getting this? In this way the lattice diagram is constructed. So now if you want to know the what is the value at your receiving end after some time. So up to time t, what is the magnitude? Here the magnitude will be equal to 0. You have to take the sum of the values up to that instant. Let us assume between t to 3t, how to find it? You have to take the sum of all the values up to there. So this will become equal to 1 plus alpha r. So this will become equal to 1 plus alpha r. Just take the sum with those signs. So again, let us assume after 3t. So after 3t up to 5t you want to find. Here the sum of the values will be 1 plus alpha r minus alpha r, minus alpha r plus alpha r cancel out. So minus alpha r square is there. So this will become 1 minus alpha r square. Getting this? This is the magnitude of the voltage, that is transmitted voltage up to this point. Again similar way, from instant 5t up to 7t, what is the magnitude? Again take the sum, this will become 1 plus alpha r cube. Again let us assume from 7t onwards, if you want to find it, this will become 1 minus alpha r to the power of 4. In this way you have to find it. So same thing is the case in the sending end. Sending end, if you are taking up to time 2t, what is the magnitude? Take the sum up to here, it becomes 1. Again from 2t to 4t, the sum will be 1 plus alpha r minus alpha r. Again it will become 1. Again here also 1 plus alpha r minus alpha r square, like that you calculate it, again it becomes 1. Same thing is the case here also, it becomes 1. In this way I have to calculate my voltage. So you will get out how to find in between the transmission line. Let us assume if you know the length, along that length just draw the line. So whichever time you want to find it, draw the line from here. So they are intersecting at some particular point. So up to this point, take the sum of the values up to there. Let us assume I want to find at this point. So here how much is there? Here it is 1. Here it is alpha r, here it is minus alpha r. So how is the how much is the magnitude here? The magnitude here will be equal to 1. The magnitude here will be equal to 1, but the magnitude is changing at different instances of time. So let us assume I am finding it up to this point. So at this point if you are calculating, at this point how much will be there? Here it is 1, here it is alpha r. So here it will be 1 plus alpha r. So here if you are calculating, it becomes 1. Again here it is changing. 1 minus alpha r square is coming. So like that it will go on changing at any location. So I can find the value at any location in the transmission line, and at any instant of time I can find what is the value of the voltage that is transmitted, or what is the value of the voltage that is reflected, or what is the voltage that is incident. Incident voltage means the wave that is traveling to that direction. Reflected means this is the value that is reflecting back. Okay, getting it? So let us try to draw the diagram for the voltage magnitude, how it is changing. So first I am taking the case when your reflection coefficient is greater than 0. When your reflection coefficient is greater than 0, I am plotting versus VR. Getting this one? So at different instances of time, up to time t, the value will be equal to 0 at the receiving end. So let us assume this is equal to magnitude 1. So alpha r is greater than 0, please remember this one. So after this, it is becoming 1 plus alpha r. 1 plus alpha r means 1 plus some value, it is greater than 1, you agree with me? So this 1 plus alpha will be greater than this much. This is at time instant t. So up to 3t, the same thing is maintained, agree with me? So up to 3t, same thing is maintained. So after 3t, it becomes 1 minus alpha r square. So alpha r is greater than 1, so this value will become less than 1. Getting this, again it will proceed up to instant of 5t. So at 5t again, it becomes 1 plus alpha r cube. So 1 plus alpha r cube, it will rise again. Again it will proceed up to instant of 7t. So again it will come down. So like that it will proceed. So let us assume it is extending up to infinite. If it is extending up to infinite, so the value of Vr I can write as 1 plus alpha r minus alpha r plus alpha r square plus alpha r square plus alpha r cube. Like this it will extend. So if you go on extending up to infinite, so finally it will stabilize at the value of 1. That means these oscillations will continue and finally it will stabilize at infinity. It will reach your rated value of the voltage. This is for alpha r is greater than 0. You can see when alpha r is greater than 0 or reflection coefficient is greater than 0, it is oscillating about the value. That means it is going above 1 and below 1. So the oscillations are coming. So that's why this is called as the underdamped system. This is called as underdamped system. So let us see the case when the value of this alpha r is less than 0. That means alpha r is negative. Then what is going to happen? So I am taking again the case when Vr is equal to 1. So let us try to calculate at time t is equal to, at time t, so t value will be equal to 1 plus alpha r. So alpha r is less than 1, so this value will be less than 1. So this value is reached here, sorry. So some value is reached. So again this is maintained constant. So up to time instant 3t. At 3t it becomes 1 minus alpha r square. So 1 minus alpha r square, so negative square will become positive, but again you are subtracting from 1. So it is still increased, so little bit it is increased. So again take the instant of 5t. At 5t it becomes 1 plus alpha r cube. Alpha r cube will be negative again. Again it will be like this only. So it will go on changing like this. And finally at infinite time it will reach the value of the voltage V. You can see here there are no oscillations. Slowly it is increasing or slowly reaching the destination. That's why this we can call as the overdamped system. Up to here it is clear to you? Let us try to calculate how to calculate the value of the current at an instant. For the case of current, there is a reflection or sending end, that reflection coefficient will be opposite to that of the voltage, because we know the voltage value of the current at any instant is equal to incident value plus reflected value. We know this. So the incident value will be equal to the incident voltage divided by Zc. This is known. Whereas the reflection value will be equal to minus Vr by Zc. So what is Vr? Vr is equal to, because we know this is Vi by Zc, and this Vr is equal to alpha. So that is, assume reflection coefficient I am taking as alpha. So alpha times of Vi by Zc. Or we can tell that the reflection coefficient for the case of Ir is coming as minus alpha. So whatever is the coefficient that is coming for the case of voltage, for current it will be opposite to that one. You agree with me? So that's why we have to change all the coefficients accordingly. So same thing, I am going to change the signs everywhere. So then we will try to calculate the value of current. So here one is the incident wave. When it reaches here, the reflection coefficient, previously it is alpha r, here it will become minus alpha r. So this will become minus alpha r. That minus alpha r will reach here, getting it? So when minus alpha r reach here, the reflection coefficient for voltage we got as minus 1. So for current it will be plus 1. So this will again becomes minus alpha r. So minus alpha r has reached here. So this will become minus of minus, this become plus. Plus alpha r square has reached here. So this plus alpha r square, when reached here, it will become plus alpha r square again will reach. This is plus alpha r square. this will become minus alpha r cube. This is minus alpha r cube. This is minus alpha r cube. So this becomes minus alpha r cube has reached here. So here minus of minus, this become plus. So reflection coefficients will change like this. So when the reflection coefficients are changed, so now you can calculate at any instant. So let us assume I want to find the current at this instant. Current at this instant will be 1. So 1 is the value of the voltage. So we have to multiply with 1 divided by Zc. Whatever the value is there, just divide with Zc. So let us assume I want to find up to this instant. So what should I do? Do the sum up to here. So sum up to here will be equal to 1 minus alpha r divided by Zc. So what we will get? 1 minus 2 times of alpha r by Zc. This is the value we get after instant from 2t time 2t to 4t. That's value is same. So let us assume I want to find between instant 4t to 6t. So at this instant, what will be there? Take the sum of the coefficient again for the current. So this will become equal to 1 minus alpha r. It become minus alpha r plus alpha r square plus alpha r square. So this will become equal to 1 minus 2 times of alpha r plus 2 times of alpha r square divided by Zc. So this way we can get it. So similar way I can calculate it every instant. So same way if you want to calculate the current at the receiving end. So current at the receiving end up to this instant, it will become 1. This plus becomes minus alpha r. So again at this instant if you want to find it, so this will become equal to sum up to here 1 minus alpha r, this will become 1 minus 2 times of alpha r plus alpha r square. So at this instant if you calculate, this will become 1 minus 2 times of alpha r plus alpha r square. This is the value of the current at this instant. Like that every instant we can go on calculating this. So let us take this side. So here at this instant we got as 1 minus 2 times of alpha r by Zc. Here we get 1 minus 2 times of alpha r by Zc. One more extra term is added, that is 2 times of alpha r square by Zc, or there is a change, 2 times of alpha r square by Zc. So let us try to summarize how the current equation will go on changing. So initially it started with 1 by Zc. Then it is changed by 2 times of alpha r by Zc. It is decreased because we got the value above as 1 minus 2 times of alpha r by Zc. Getting this one? So same thing I have represented here. 2 times of alpha r by Zc, it is decreased. So after that, again one more term is added, plus 2 times of alpha r square by Zc. It is increased. Again it will remain constant. So this is up to 40 and this will be up to 60. So after 60 what happens? Again it will change. So the value will go on changing like this. And finally it will stabilize at a value Is is equal to 1 by RL. I am just taking the summarization of all the things. So the reflection coefficient for voltage. First, whatever the reflection coefficient you are getting for the voltage. So for current, the reflection coefficient will be the opposite to the reflection coefficient of the voltage. So please remember this one while calculating the current. Remaining things will be same. If you want to calculate the value at any instant, what you have to do? You have to take the sum up to that particular instant. That means what we have to do? I have to draw two Bewley lattice diagrams. One lattice diagram will be for voltage. Another lattice diagram will be for current. Then based on that, I can calculate the voltage or current at any instant. Let us take for example, I want to find at some instant in the intermediate one. At some particular time, let us assume I want to find at the instant of 3t at this location. How can I find at this location? Take the sum of the values up to that position. Like if I want to find the current at this position, the current will be equal to 1, and after this, this is equal to minus alpha r, and here it is equal to minus alpha r. So total value will be equal to 1 minus 2 times of alpha r. So current will be 1 minus 2 times of alpha r divided by Zc. That will be the value of current at this instant at this particular time, that means at 3t. Getting this? Likewise, we can calculate the value of current or the voltage at any location easily. I hope this Bewley lattice diagram and how to calculate the voltage or current at any instant or any particular location of the transmission line is clear to you. If you still have any queries, you can leave your comments in the comment section below. I will answer to your queries from there. Thank you. Thank you very much.